Sing this with us.
Lord, I want to feel your heart, see the worth of your eyes. I want to be your hands and feet, I want to live a life that leads. Ready yourself, ready yourself. Shine the light of Jesus in the darkest night. Oh, ready yourselves, may the powers of darkness tremble as our praises rise. Until the whole world hears, Lord, we are calling out, lifting up your name for all to hear the sound. Like voices in the wilderness, draws near, we'll sing until the whole world hears.
Let's sing it loud so the whole world hears. Next verse.
Lord, let your sleeping giant rise, catch the demons by surprise. Holy nation sanctified, let this be our battle cry. Ready yourselves, ready yourselves. Let us shine the light of Jesus in the darkest night. Oh, ready yourselves, may the powers of darkness tremble as our praises rise. Until the whole world hears, Lord, we are calling out, lifting up your name for all to hear the sound. Like voices in the wilderness, we're crying out. As the day draws near, we'll sing until the whole world hears.
Of God this morning. Amen. Continue to worship with us as we sing great things. Sing this with us.
Come, let us worship our King. Come, let us bow at his feet.
We have done great things. See what our Savior has done. See how his love overcomes. He has done great things. He has done great things. O hero of heaven, you conquered the grave. You free every captive and break every chain, O God. You have done great things. We dance in your freedom, you're awake and alive. Oh Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh God, you have done great things.
Done great things in your life this morning. Sing this verse with us.
You've been faithful through every storm. You'll be faithful forevermore. You have done great things. And I know you will do it again. For your promise is yes and amen. You have done great things. God, you do great things. Oh, hero of heaven, your name to the grave. You pray every captive and break every chain. Oh, God, you have done great things. Oh, dance in your freedom, awake and alive. Oh, Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh, God, you have done great things. Hallelujah, God, above it all. Hallelujah, God, unshakable. Hallelujah, you have done great things.
Sing that with us.
Hallelujah, God, above it all. Hallelujah, God, unshakable. Hallelujah, God, you have done great things. You've done great things.
Oh, hero of heaven, you conquered the grave. You braid every captive and break every chain, oh God. You have done great things. We dance in your freedom, awake and alive. Oh, Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh, God, you have done great things. You have done great things. Oh, God, you do great things.
Friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to care. Never be discouraged. share. Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer.
Sing the last verse. For that this morning. Amen. Sing these words with us.
You give life. You are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great.
As we sing this next verse,
you give light, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you.
Thank you for the good worship this morning. I read a book a couple of years ago, and I came across the book a couple of weeks ago and decided to reread the book. The title captured me when I first took it into my Kindle library to read it. Don't sweat the small stuff. You ever sweat small stuff? Worry about things that really are not worthy of our concern. There are things that make us worry that are worthy of a moment of concern and worthy of a prayer whispered that God would reach in, no doubt about it. But how many times have I invested way too much energy in something that is just really here for a moment and gone in a moment, right? You know, one of the things that, and I don't know why I'm wired this way, but one of the things that really bothers me is when I am in a line of cars waiting to go through the drive-thru, and there's a car that leaves more than a car length space between themselves and the one in front of them. Why does that bother me so bad? We were in a line the other day. And by the way, we picked Em up from school Friday for the first time in over a year. That baby was excited. We were excited. We said, do you want to go get a slushie? And she said, oh, yeah. And so we went to Sonic to get her a slushie. And as we're going through the line, Becky said, do you want a snack? She said, I'll take a hamburger. So that baby got a hamburger at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and we went home and enjoyed that time with her. But earlier in the week, Becky and I were in a line somewhere, and sure enough, this person was, and I think they were on their phone. I was trying to diagnose, why in the world are they hanging back? You know, I'm wanting to get our order and move on. And I didn't beat my horn, I didn't shout, but I'm getting worked up. And Becky says, you need to just relax. And I said, well, why in the world won't they pull up? She said, they're going to pull up in a second. They've got to get their order. It'll be all right. Why do I sweat the small stuff? And the Lord's has been challenging me on that point, to regain some focus when it comes to the things that are worthy of that kind of investment of energy. And so I was reading in the scripture, and I came across Hebrews 3, verses 12 and 13. And he says, see to it, brothers and sisters, that none of you has a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God, but encourage one another daily, as long as it's called today, so that none of you may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. Now that has a world of application attached to it. But believe it or not, it even has a little bit of an application attached to it when it comes to me losing my cool because I'm waiting in a line and the people ahead of me are not moving as quickly through the line as I think they should. More than I realize, in moments like that, sin is deceiving me and causing some hardening of my heart, if you will. And there are more critical issues than this. But it's a reminder this morning that we need to remember to not sweat the small stuff, to let go of some things, to breathe and enjoy the moment that God has given to us. And so as I was thinking about this the other day, the Lord just started impressing some thoughts on my mind, and I've got those thoughts on this page. And this is a different kind of message this morning, but the Lord has designed it for a reason. And somebody, and I'm one of those somebodies, needs to hear some of what God impressed in my heart the other day as I was writing these down. One of the first things, and this is a big thing really, life is too short to not realize it's not what we know about God that saves us, but it's what He knows and that He loves us that is our salvation. And the reason I got to thinking about this, and I shared it with Wednesday morning Bible study this past week, is I was thinking, how many times do we get so tied up in the intricacies of biblical doctrine that we lose the joy of our salvation? And we think that sometimes that it's the effort that we invest that causes us to continue to be saved, and we forget that the same grace that saved us in that beginning moment that we bowed before Him is still the grace that saves us all these years later, however long we've been trusting in the Lord. And life is just too short for us to misunderstand what our privilege is when it comes to opening this book. This needs to be, His Word needs to be one of the joys of our lives. Amen? Yeah. And not just an obligation, not just a duty, not an attempt for us to keep ourselves saved. We can't keep ourselves saved. God alone is our salvation. Amen? God alone is the one in His love who has redeemed us for all of eternity. And that song that Jennifer just shared and the praise team just shared speaks to that point. That there is nothing that can separate us from Him and from His great love for us, and that we need to learn to depend more and more upon His saving presence in our lives. So life is too short to not realize that it's not what we know about God that is our salvation. There's more that we don't know than we do know. Amen? And the longer we serve Him, the more we understand that. The more we learn Scripture, the more we realize how much we have to learn to come to an understanding of the fullness of what He has offered us here. But then also, life is too short to leave your Bible on the shelf. That's a book we ought to open every day, y'all. And I know we don't have time to do in-depth Bible study every single day, perhaps, but there's no reason why, with the tools that are available in our lifetime, that we're not able to be influenced by His Word, whether it's by an audible reading that we receive or sitting down with the book. I believe there's value in sitting down with the book. You know, my mind works this way. I can read a passage of Scripture and God impresses it upon my life in such a way that in my mind, I know that it's in the book of Romans, and I know that it's the 8th chapter, and I know that it's over on this side, this column. I may not know the verse number every time, but I can see it in my mind's eye, that passage of Scripture that God impressed in my heart. And life's too short for us to leave the Bible on the shelf. And so make Bible reading and Bible study a part of your daily life. God will use it in your life to whisper to you those keynote truths that He is wanting to bring to bear in your life. And I'm telling you, of all the things that we can do that can keep us from having our hearts hardened by sin's deceitfulness, being people of the book, people of the Bible, is one of the chief things that we can do that will keep us moving in that Godward direction that our Father has called us. And then I wrote down, life is too short to waste my time on foolish endeavors. And we've all wasted our time on foolish endeavors. And sometimes for me, a foolish endeavor is to try to fix something that I think I might be able to fix, but I'm not sure I can fix. And then I try to fix it, and I end up calling Eric or someone like that after all to come and fix what I made a mess of. Christian, how many times have I called you and said, Christian, I tried to fix this plumbing issue. Go ahead and send one of Frank's Hill Plumbing guys to come and fix it. And if I had called them first, it would have been less of a job. Life's too short for us to invest ourselves in things that we would be better to leave to someone else. And it's not just fix-it tasks. There are so many things that sometimes we get wrapped up in, and then we realize, wow, I wasted a day on that. And I could have been doing something so much more valuable than what I did in that moment. And life is too short to stay mad over things you can't change. What are you mad about this morning? Who is someone that you're just really aggravated with this morning? And what has being aggravated with them done to change that situation? You with me? I'm telling you, life is too short to stay mad over things that we cannot change. Now, if there's something that is worthy of our concern, I tell you, one of the greatest things you can do to bring about a change is to involve God in it. And the way we do that is to bend our knees in prayer and say, Lord, here's this situation, here's this relationship, here's this decision. Lord, it's got me all worked up. I'm even angry over what's before me. And I pray, Lord, that You would guide me through this situation and that You would allow me to let go of it and put it in Your hands. If you're mad about something this morning, why don't you right now just put it in God's hands? Just let it go. It'll rob you of your joy if you let it. Life is too short to live only for the accumulation of wealth. Life is too short to live only for the accumulation of wealth. All of that stuff you're gathering up, you're going to leave it for someone else one day. I'm not saying you shouldn't be concerned about leaving an inheritance for your children or grandchildren. I'm not talking about that, but I'm saying there's more to life than just working and getting more stuff, whether it's dollars in the bank or furniture in the house or cars in the driveway or boats at the lake. There's more to life than that. And if you're not careful, you get caught up in a treadmill of just moving from one thing to another. Just one thing to another. And life is too short to get on that treadmill. Listen to what the Lord speaks to your heart today. Life is too short to leave God at church just for a weekly visit. Paul said, as he wrote to the Thessalonians, in 1 Thessalonians 5:17, he said this, "Pray without ceasing." And when he said that, he introduced us to the reality that our relationship with God, the potential is there for 24/7. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Just as we shouldn't leave our Bible on the shelf, we shouldn't leave God at church on Sunday mornings. We need to open our lives to His living presence day by day, moment by moment, relationship by relationship, issue by issue, opening our lives to Him and availing ourselves to the opportunity to walk with Him and talk with Him all along life's way. When you do that, you find yourself not only talking to Him about what you need help with, but you find yourself talking to Him about the things that you're thankful for, the things that you count as a blessing. What an incredible opportunity is ours to walk with God day by day, hour by hour. Let that relationship become the priority of your life, and it'll change all of life. Life is too short to not love your neighbor and your family. It kind of leans on one from earlier, that life's too short to stay mad over what we cannot change. The other side of the coin, life's too short not to love the people God's put around us. Who's someone that you are estranged from that relationship might be restored if you would be the person who's big enough to take the first step? To step back into the presence of that person's aura and to speak to them words of friendship and words of love. Now, the longer you've been estranged, the more suspect they're going to be of that greeting. So it may take some persistence. It may take more than one call, more than one visit, more than one expression of loving kindness. But I'm telling you, life is too short for us to be separated from the people that God has made a part of our lives. If you're estranged from family this morning, I beg with you, do what is necessary to restore that relationship. It is worth every bit of effort, every bit of tension that is involved in being restored in that relationship with family and with people who have been your neighbors and your friends over the years. Lord, help us with that, because life's too short to let those things go by. There will come a time when there's no more opportunity to mend those fences. Today is the day to mend those fences, because tomorrow may be too late. Life is too short to neglect the children in your world. Moms and dads get busy. Amen? I mean, we've got so much on our plates. But I'm going to tell you, you will not believe, unless you're already in my shoes, you will not believe how quickly those years go by and your kids are no longer underfoot. Take every opportunity you have to relish the moments that you have with the children that God has blessed you with. There are times that I think about times with my kids, and it just seems like it was yesterday. And my son will be 46 years old this year, and my daughter will be 41. And I cannot believe that they're 41 and 46. I can't believe I'm 66. Life speeds past. As you have opportunity to be with your kids, grandparents, as you have opportunity to be with your grandkids, take that opportunity, because it's moving at warp speed, if you will, and it gets away from us if we don't take those opportunities. Rachel's driving. Now, I told you she drove to school. My prayer life has increased. Rachel's my 16-year-old granddaughter, lives in Florence. And they told us last week, the first day that she drove, they said, Rachel's driving to school tomorrow. Man, I tell you what, I prayed all day. Lord, watch over her. That traffic at West Florence, I mean, it's tricky. And so I wrote her and I said, I heard you drove to school today. Texted her during school hours. And I can always count on my kids responding during school hours. How about you? And she writes right back. I mean, that little bubble came up with the three dots. I mean, as soon as I sent it, she's working. And she writes back and says, oh, it was fun. Yay. And I wrote back and told her, I said, I have prayed more today than I have in a long time. And she wrote back, LOLLLLLLL. Well, this week, she not only drove to school, but she picked Emma up from school one day. And I can't believe these are the things that are unfolding in the life of Rachel, who was my little granddaughter, just always underfoot, and she's growing up. And I'm cherishing the opportunities that we have to be together. And for the first time in over a year, we were in their house the other day when we went to pick Emma up from school. And man, we've learned not to take so much for granted as we've moved through COVID, haven't we? Let's not lose sight of that. And let's take opportunity to be with those children who are in our worlds, because it won't be long until they're out and on their own, establishing households of their own. And that's another exciting season of life. But please don't, those of you who have children, don't take it for granted. These are precious times. Life's too short to be unhappy all the time. Life's too short to not take a risk. Life's too short to be arguing with people over the small stuff. It's just too short. Life's too short to be so worried about the details of a story that's being told. You ever done that? Someone's telling the story and they say last Tuesday, and you say, no, it was Wednesday. Well, who cares? You know? Life's too short. And we went to McDonald's. No, we went to Burger King. Who cares? Who cares? Life's too short to get hung up on all of those details, all of the small stuff. I've been praying that God would help me to really enjoy the moments that I have with people, family, church members, friends, people I'm meeting for the first time, to really just disengage a little bit, and not disengage in the relationship, but disengage my mind from wanting to race to what's to be said next, just to listen and drink in that moment what someone is taking the time to share with me. Yesterday, we had the opportunity to be with Becky's mom, Molly, and we were going out for dinner. And so we went to dinner, and Molly was in the back seat. We were driving her car, and Becky was up front. And so I said, when we head back home, why don't you get in the back with your mom, and y'all talk, and I'll just be the chauffeur. And she said, okay. So she got in the back seat with her mom, and we went to Sheely's to eat, which is about, I don't know, about 25 minutes from Molly's house. So for 25, 30 minutes, as we're driving back to Lexington to Molly's house, she's telling Becky stories from her growing up years and her teenage years. And Beck's like, Mom, you've never told me this before. And so she's just telling all of these stories, and it was a time for Becky and I just to listen. And we were hearing things we had never heard about before. And it, as we were listening to her, I thought, Lord, help me to take more opportunity for moments like this, where you're just listening to someone's story, not interjecting, not identifying. I read something this week that said that we need to be careful that we're not always rushing ahead when we're in conversation with someone to put in our piece of story that fits with their piece of story. Sometimes we just need to listen and value that person and value what they're saying to us in that moment. And I've asked God, Lord, help me with that. Help me to realize that life is too short not to listen to what someone is sharing from their lives, that is a unique opportunity to connect with that person, but also to understand how God has been at work in their lives. And then the last one I have on the page is, life is too short to just do nothing. Life is too short to just do nothing. I remember one day we were working on something, a group of fellas, and we were trying to find our way, what we needed to do next. We were working on a project, and someone said, well, what do we need to do now? And one of the other guys said, I don't know, but we need to do something because we've been standing here too long studying this situation. And it's true, you know, there's a time to pray, but then there's a time to work. Amen? I mean, there's a time to plan, but then there's a time to execute. There's a time to count the cost and get everything organized concerning your move forward, but then there's a time just to move forward. Analysis paralysis. That tendency to want to have everything perfectly addressed before we take the first step. And I understand Jesus did say, count the cost or else you'll begin to build a tower and you'll never finish it, and it'll stand as a monument to the fact that you weren't prepared for that project. I understand preparation. But Lord, help us when we're doing the best we can to prepare to finally step out and take the risk to do that something that is next. Because, you know, sometimes until we do that something that is next, we cannot see the steps that are beyond that. Sometimes you have to take a few steps to understand this is what we're supposed to do. This is what comes next. We can't always get that perfectly analyzed just sitting in our recliner trying to determine how we put it all together. Well, the point of this message is we need to be careful not to take our lives for granted. We need to get around to doing the things that God has impressed upon our lives we need to do. Pay that visit. Make that phone call. Offer that willingness to help someone with a need they have. Lord, help us to get outside of the schedules that we've made for ourselves, to take those turns in some obscure direction that ends up really being His plan for us in that moment. Don't allow self-absorbed living to cause your heart to be hardened to the blessings that God is wanting to pour out in your life. Life's too short to just live for yourself. Life's too short to not love those God has put around you. I've decided, with the Lord's help, that I'm going to go see my dad every 3 months. Used to be a couple times a year. Birthday, maybe Father's Day. And the Lord pressed in my heart recently, life's too short not to go see Him more. Because one day, that opportunity will be in the past. And I don't know what the fill in the blank is for you this morning, but I guarantee you that as God led me to preach this message, He's already shown you something that applies in your life when it comes to saying life's too short not to. Listen to what the Spirit is saying to you. Do not be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. What is sin? Living for ourselves. Putting ourselves above God and everything else. Do not let the deceitfulness of self-absorbed living keep you from enjoying the opportunities that God is giving you in this day and in this time. This week, I'm liable to go through a drive-thru line. And if I have to, I'll get out of my car and go inside. But I'm not going to get mad at that person in front of me for not tightening up the line. Because that's just crazy. That's crazy to get upset over something like that. Life's too short. Lord, I pray this morning that whatever it is you're wanting to say to us as individuals about enjoying this time that you have given us in our lives, I pray, Lord, that your Spirit would cause us to see and understand what you are saying to us as individuals. How in the world can I address everything that's going on in everyone's lives this morning? I can't. All I can do is talk about what's going on in my life and pray that there's a connection, that there's something that causes a spark of thought and imagination that challenges us to get outside of the routine that has kept us from greater things. So whatever that is, whether it's taking our Bible off the shelf or praying and talking to you more throughout the week or loving those you've put around us or letting go of the hurts that we can't change, whatever it is, help us with it, Lord, that we might redeem the day that we have, that we might live in the moment that you've given us, and that we might find more joy as we walk this planet on our way to glory. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Who are we that you would be mindful of us? What do you see? This worth looking our way. We are free in ways that we never should be. Sweet release from the grip of these chains. Like hinges straining from the weight, my heart no longer can keep from singing. All that is within me cries, for you alone be glorified. Emmanuel, God with us. My heart sings don't deserve your glory, still you show a love we cannot afford. Like hinges straining from the weight, my heart no longer can keep from singing. All that is within me cries, for you alone be glorified, Emmanuel. such a tiny offering compared to Calvary. Nevertheless, we lay it at your feet.
Sing those words again.
Such a tiny offering.